In previous classes, we have discussed how to determine the support moments of the two span and three span continuous beam when the end supports are simply supported. Today, I am going to speak how to determine the support moments of the beam using Clapeyron theorem of three moments when one end or both ends are fixed. These are the different types of beam. So in the case of propped cantilever beam, here this is one moment and here the moment is your zero. At the propped end, the moment is your zero. So this case, you require one three moment equation. You have to use here the Clapeyron theorem three moments and you have to find out one equation. Then after analysis of this equation, you'll get what is the unknown moment at the support A. But how will find out here? How will find out here? Because here you see, this is propped cantilever, and here there is you are having one span. Here there is having one span. But this Clapeyron theorem of three moments is your applicable for any two consecutive span. Any two consecutive span. So, but here there is one span. So how you will find out the unknown moment at A using the Clapeyron theorem of three moments? So this is very important. So if the end is your fixed, then in that case, what you have to do and how you have to find out the moment at the fixed end. So what you have to do here, so you have to take the zero span here. You have to take the zero span length here. And this support A is your extent to A dash. And you have to take this is zero span and A dash, this is the simply supported end. So you have to use the Clapeyron theorem to the span A dash A and AB. Then after simplification of this one, you'll get one equation and then you'll find out what is the unknown value at MA. Here you see fixed beam. This is one span fixed beam. So here this side is your fixed and this side is also fixed. So here this is unknown and this is unknown. So you have to find out these two moments. So here you need two equation. Here you need two equation. So how you'll get the two equation? Because this is one, but here there is two unknown moments M and MB. But in this case, how you'll find out the unknown moments M and MB using the Clapeyron theorem of three moments. So what you have to do? So this is the support A. So here the support A, you have to extend to the support A dash. And you have to take that support is your simply supported. And you have to take, this is the zero span here. You have to take this is zero span. A dash A is the zero span. And this side also, this is fixed end. And here also the support B, you have to extend to B dash. And you have to take B, B dash as a zero span length. You have to take B, B dash as a zero span length. And the B dash is your simply supported. Simply supported means the B, the moment at B dash is your zero. And here A dash is your simply supported, means moment at A dash is your equal to zero. Then what you have to do? Then you have to apply three moment equation. That is to the span A dash A and AB. You have to apply three moment equation to the span A dash A, then AB. So you will get one equation in terms of MA and MB. Then you have to apply three moment equation to the span AB and BB dash, AB and BB dash. Then you will get another equation in terms of MA and MB. Then after simplification of these two equations, you will find out what is the unknown moments at end A and at end B. Here you see. So this is two span continuous beam with end A is your fixed and end C is your fixed. So here, the moment at A is your MA, and moment at B is your MB, and moment at C is MC. Three unknown moments. This case, three unknown moments. So you require three equations to get these three unknown moments. So here, what you have to do? Here, what you have to do? So you have to introduce one zero span length, zero span beam, A dash A. This A support you have to extend to A dash, and you have to take A dash A as a zero span beam. And similarly, this side also you have to extend C to C dash, and you have to take C and C dash as a zero span beam. and here you take the end c dash is your zero, and here take end a dash is your the moment at end a dash is zero, and the moment at end c dash is zero due to simply supported n. So only the moment ma and mb and mc, this is the three moments. So this is three moment unknown moments, and these three moment you have to find out using the Clapeyron theorem of three moments. So what you have to do here, so first you have to apply the three moment equation or Clapeyron theorem of three moment to the span a dash a and ab. You will get one equation. Then you have to apply to the span ab and bc, you will get the second equation. Then you will apply to the span bc and cc dash, you will get third equation. You will get third equation. Then after simplification of these three equation, you will find out what is the moment at end a and interior support b, and at end c ma mb and mc. Similarly, this is also two span continuous beam, and here this is fixed and c is simply supported. So you know what is the moment here. This is unknown moment ma, this is interior support unknown moment mb, but due to simply supported end, the moment here is your zero. So here you need two equation, because these two is your unknown. So here you need two equation. So what you have to do, because this is two span, so here you have to introduce one zero span length beam. So that is, you have to extend the support a to a dash, and you have to take a dash as a simply supported n. So a dash a is your zero span length, but the moment at the support a dash is your m a dash, and this is your equal to zero. So here the moment is your ma, and this is the moment mb. So first you have to apply here the Clapeyron theorem of three moment to the span a dash a and ab, you will get one equation. Then you have to apply to the span ab and bc, you will get second equation. Then after simplification of these two equation, you will find out what is the value of moment at a and b. Here the moment is your zero, you know. Here also you see, this is three span continuous beam, and here this end is your fixed and this end is your fixed. That is the end at a, this is fixed, and the support D is your fixed. So what is the moment here ma, and this is bc is your interior support. So the moment here mb and the moment here mc, and the moment at D is your md. So here four unknown, here this is four unknowns. So you need four equations here. Here you need four equation. So what you have to do, so this is fixed end, so you have to extend the support a to a dash, and you have to take a dash as zero span. Then at a dash, the moment is your zero, you have to take simply supported, and here also you have to take extend this support d to d dash, and take d dash as simply supported, and d dash is the zero span length. Then apply equation, the three moment equation to the span a dash a and ab, you will get one equation. Then apply to the span ab and bc, you will get second equation. Then apply to the span bc and cd, you will get third equation. Then apply to the span cd and d dash, then you will get the fourth equation. Then after simplification of this fourth four equation, you will get the value of moment ma, mb, mc and md. Similarly, this is also continuous beam. So here this end is your fixed, that is support A is fixed, and support B is your simply supported, and BC is your interior support. So what is the moment here at support A, MA? What is the moment at B, MB? What is the moment at C, MC? But moment at D is your zero due to simply supported N. So here you need three equation. So you have to apply the zero span length beam at the fixed end A, a dash and a dash is you have to take simply supported, and moment of the a dash is your zero. Then apply Clapeyron theorem of three moment to the span a dash a and ab, you will get one equation. And ab and bc, you will get second equation, and bc and cd, you will get third equation. Then after simplification of these three equation, you will find out what is the moment at a, moment at b and moment at c. Similarly, this is one beam. So here this is your continuous beam, this is continuous beam with overhanging at end D, overhanging. This is the overhanging portion D, and A is the piston. A is the piston. So here you see, here there is the unknown moment MA, piston moment, and this is the interior support moment MB. This is also interior support moment MC, and here you know the moment MT. By considering this as a cantilever beam, you have to find out what is the moment here. You have to find out what is the moment here, and this moment is your known moment. So how many unknown here? MA, MB, and MC. MA, MB, MC. So this case also you need three equations. So you have to extend A to A dash and take here A dash as a simply supported end, and this is the zero span length, and you have to apply Clapeyron theorem of three moment to span A dash A and AB. You will get one equation. Then apply Clapeyron theorem of three moment to span AB and BC. You will get second equation. Then apply Clapeyron theorem of three moment to the span BC and CD. You will get third equation. Then after simplification of these three equations, we'll find out what is the unknown moments at A, B, and C. So these are the different cases, that is one end fixed or other end is your fixed. So using the Clapeyron theorem, we will find out the moments. So introducing the zero span or the fixed end, then you can find out the unknown support moments. This is the Clapeyron theorem already I have discussed. So MA L1 by I1 plus 2MB L1 by I1 plus L2 by I2 plus MC L2 by I2 is equal to minus 6A1 small a1 by I1 L1 minus 6A2 small a2 by I2 L2. So when the beam is of non-uniform section, you have to apply this equation. And when the beam is of uniform section, you have to apply this equation. MA L1 plus 2MB L1 plus L2 plus MC L2 is equal to minus 6A1 small a1 by L1 minus 6A2 small a2 by L2. So this is the two equation you have to apply to any consecutive span. So this is proved to cantilever beam. How to find out the unknown moment at the fixed end of the proved to cantilever beam? Because this end is your simply supported. So this is prop to cantilever beam, and this end is your simply supported, and this end is your fixed. So you have to find out at the fixed end the unknown moments using the Clapeyron theorem of three moments. So already I have discussed how to find out this one. So at the fixed end, you have to introduce one zero span length beam. Zero span length beam. That is, you have to extend the A to A dash and take A dash as your simply supported, and the length of the beam is your zero. The length of the beam is your zero, means L is your equal to zero. Here the length is your zero, and here also there is no loading. So the area of this also zero, and centroidal distance is also zero. So everything is your zero in zero span beam. But here this is the proved to cantilever beam, and the length of the proved to cantilever beam is your L. And the load you are having on the proved to cantilever beam, this is W per meter rod. So if A is the fixed support, extend the beam from A to A dash of span zero length, and the support A dash is simply supported. Already I have explained here. The simply supported bending moment diagram of span AB is parabola, because here this is the UDL. So due to this UDL, what is the simply supported bending moment diagram? So this is parabola. This is parabola. And what is the maximum moment at the midpoint of the beam? So this is W L square by 8, you know. The maximum bending moment at midpoint of span AB is equal to W L square by 8. The centroid of this BMD is from support A and B is your L by 2. So what is the centroidal distance of this area from this side or this side? So this is L by 2, because the centroidal distance, the CG point is situated just midpoint of this area. So this side the centroidal distance L by 2, and this side the centroidal distance L by 2. So this is the simply supported bending moment diagram of span A dash A and AB, because here there is zero span and here there is no loading, zero. Only the free bending moment diagram of span AB is your this one. Then A1, this is the area of free BMD of span A dash A. here there is a dash is your zero here, because there is no free bending moment diagram due to zero spun and there is no loading. And what is the area of this one? Area of the parabola, A2 is the area of free BMD of span AB. So this is 2/3 into base into height, 2/3 into L into WL square by 8. This is your equal to WL cube by 12. Then what is the centroidal distance of area A1 from support A dash? A dash, because here there is no area, so zero spun. So the centroidal distance is also zero. And what is the area of this parabola from the support B? So this is your L by 2. What is the centroidal distance of parabola from the support B? So this is your L by 2. This is the support moment diagram. You don't know, you have to find out this moment MA, because here the moment is your zero and here the moment is your MA. Here the moment is your MA. You have to find out this moment using the Clapeyron theorem of three moments. Then apply three moment theorem to the span A dash and AB. You have to apply three moment equation or Clapeyron theorem of three moment to the span A dash A and AB. You have to apply to these two consecutive span. So what is the Clapeyron theorem? MA L1 plus 2MB L1 plus L2 plus MC L2 is equal to minus 6 A1s A1 by L1 minus 6 A2 A2 by L2. Though the three moment equation applied to span A dash and AB, in the above equation put the value. So you have to put all the value, because here you see, this is, you have to take, here you see, when you apply the Clapeyron theorem of three moments, so this is MA, MB and MC. So this is appeal for the span AB and BC, ABC, but here this is A, this is B and this is C. So the moment at A dash, MA dash is equal to MA is equal to zero, and this is simply supported, equal to MA, and MC is equal to MB, and this is also simply supported, and this is also zero. MA is equal to MA dash is zero due to simply supported and zero spun and no load, and MB is equal to MA, and MC is equal to MB, this is also zero due to simply supported end. And what is the area? This is the area of this one is your zero, A1 zero, and A2 is your equal to this one, A1 zero, A2 is your equal to WL cube by 12, and the centroidal distance of zero span length A1 zero, and A2 is your equal to L by 2, and L1 zero, zero span length, and L2 is your equal to small L, that the length is your given small L. Then the moment of inertia is your same. I1 is equal to I, I2 is equal to I. So apply this equation. So after putting these values, I will get MA dash 0 plus 2MA 0 plus L plus 0 is equal to minus 6 WL cube by 12 into L by 2. Then the moment at A is equal to minus WL square by 8. So this is the support moment. This moment you got WL square by 8, and this is your negative. The support moment is your always negative. This is WL to by 8. Then after getting the moment, then what you have to do? You have to find out the reaction. You have to find out the reaction, because you have to take what is the load you are having on the beam, and you have to take the support moment what you got. So here this is minus WL square by 8 for this negative moment. So what you have to do, you have to take right side is your clockwise and left side anti-clockwise. For this negative moment, you have to take left side anti-clockwise, right side clockwise. So here this is A, MA. So you have to take negative, means this is anti-clockwise direction. And this is the reaction at A is your BA, and reaction at B is BB. Then you have to find out what is the reaction at both end, A and B, B and BB. So you have to take what is the moment about the support A, VB into L, this is anti-clockwise rotation about the support A, and this is also anti-clockwise, VB into L plus WL square by 8 is equal to clockwise moment. Clockwise moment is your W into L into centroidal distance L by 2. Then this is one equation. The anti-clockwise moment is equal to clockwise moment. Then this is another equation, the summation of the vertical force is equal to zero. So here this is VA, this is VB, this is upward force, and downward force is your W into L, W per unit term, but the length of the span is your L. So what is the total downward force W into L? So BA plus BB is your equal to W into L. So after simplification of these two equations, I will find out what is the reaction at support A and B. So the reaction at A is your 5WL by 8. Reaction at A is your 5WL by 8. And reaction at B is your 3WL by 8. This is the reaction. Then after knowing the reaction, then you can plot the shear force diagram. So what is the shear force at B? So this is right side upward force. So the shear force at B is negative. FB is equal to minus BB is equal to minus 3WL by 8. Then what is the shear force at A? So this is right side upward force negative. And due to this load, this downward force. So minus BB plus W into L. Minus BB plus W into L. So this is equal to minus 3WL by 8 plus WL is equal to 5WL by 8. So here the reaction, this is equal to the reaction at A. This is equal to the reaction at PA. This is equal to this one, 5WL by 8. Then you can plot the shear force diagram. Here this side is 3WL by 8. Then due to this UDL, so this is goes linearly. And here at the support A, the shear force value is 5WL by 8. So this side below this is negative and above this X is positive. This is the shear force diagram. Then you have to find out the point of contraflexure. What is the point of contraflexure? Where the bending moment changes its sign or the bending moment is equal to zero. This is your point of contraflexure. So you have to find out the point of contraflexure distance. So how will find out the point of contraflexure distance? So you have to take a section xx at a distance x from the support A. Then you have to find out what is the moment at the section. You have to find out what is the moment at the section. And you have to equate this moment to zero, then you will find out what is the point of contraflexure distance. Means the bending moment is at zero or bending moment change its sign here. So first you have to find out what is the moment here. Then you have to equate the moment to zero. Then you will find out what is the point of contraflexure distance. So here you take VA into X, take the moment MX about the section. VA into X, this is clockwise, and this is anti-clockwise, and due to this UDL also anti-clockwise. VA into X minus WL square by 8 minus W into X by 2. This is the moment here. This is 5WL by 8X minus WX square by 2 minus WL square by 8. This is the bending moment. But at the point of contraflexure, the bending moment is equal to 0. The point of contraflexure determined by equating the bending moment at a section xx to 0. You have to equate to 0, and this is the equation, and you will get one quadratic equation. Then after solving the quadratic equation, you will get what is the point of contraflexure distance, this one. Because this is the negative moment, this is the fist and the at the support A, this is the moment MA, and this is the free bending moment diagram due to the UDL, and this point is the point of contraflexure distance. This portion is your cancel each other. This is negative portion, this is positive portion. So this is the final bending moment diagram. So here this is the point of contraflexure distance. From this to this, this is the point of contraflexure distance. So here you got the point of contraflexure distance here, 0.25L. Then find out the maximum positive moment. Find out maximum positive moment. So where you will get the maximum positive moment? You don't know. So where the shear force is at zero, so at that position you will get the maximum bending moment. Because here you see, here shear force is at zero. Here, this is the shear force diagram, and here shear force zero. And you have to find out what is the maximum bending moment at this position. So you can find out by taking this is your X, and this you have to take L minus X. So by taking this one, the similar triangle, you can find out what is the distance of X, or you can find out by taking the section at a distance X from the this one by taking a section at a distance x from the support A, and you have to find out what is the shear force here. And you have to make the shear force to zero. So you have to take what is the shear force of the section xx. What are the forces having the left side of this one? So this is VA minus what is this force? This is W per meter run. So what is the length? Wx. VA minus Wx is equal to Fx. So you have to equate this to zero. 5WL by 8 minus Wx is equal to zero. Then after simplification of this equation, you get what is the zero shear position distance? 5L by 8. This distance is your 5L by 8. From this to this, this distance is your 5L by 8. So from the support A, at a distance 5L by 8, you will get the maximum positive moment. At this location, the maximum positive bending moment is equal to 5WL by 8 into 5L by 8. This is the reaction 5WL by 8. This is VA is equal to 5WL by 8. And what is the distance is 5L by 8 minus for this length due to UTM, W into 5L by 8 into 5L by 8 divided by 2, then minus WL square by 8, a moment here, minus WL square by 8, then the maximum positive moment is equal to minus WL square by 8, plus after simplification plus 25 WL square by 64, and this is 25 WL square by this one, this is equal to 9 WL square by 8 is equal to 0.07 WL square. So the maximum positive moment is 0.07 WL square. This is the final bending moment diagram. So the maximum positive moment here 0.07 WL square, and here the negative moment WL square by 8, and this distance is 3L by 8, and this distance from this to this is your 5L by 8, and the point of contra flexure distance is 0.25L from the support A. This is 0.25L. This is the complete diagram. The position of zero shear force and the point of contraflexure position and the maximum bending moment position. Coming to another example, this is fixed beam. So in fixed beam, so here this is your fixed end, this is also fixed end. So here the moment is your MA and here the moment is MB. And the length of the beam is your L, and the load is your present at a distance L by 3 from the support A and 2L by 3 from the support B. So you have to find out the moment MA and MB using the Clapeyron theorem of three moments. Here there is two unknown. You have to find out these two value by using the Clapeyron theorem of three moments. So how you will find out these unknown moments? Already I have explained. So at A, you have to introduce one zero span length beam. A dash and A dash is you have to take simply supported. Similarly, at B, you have to introduce one zero span length beam. B dash and B dash is you have to take simply supported A. So the moment are the simply supported at A dash and B dash is your zero. So only the moment is your MA and MB. So here you got three span. This is one zero span. Then this is the AB span. And this is also one zero span. So here what you have to do? First, you have to apply Clapeyron theorem of three moment to the span A dash A and AB. You will get one equation. Then you have to apply Clapeyron theorem of three moment to the span AB and BB dash. You will get the another equation. Then after simplification of these two equations, you will find out what is the unknown support moments at A and B. This is you see this is the fixed beam. So here this is zero span A dash A and the length is your zero, and here this is one zero span, the length is your zero, BB dash. This is the fixed beam. So first you have to draw the free bending moment diagram. So because this is the load and this is the span, and this is, if you are taking this is A and this is B and the total length is your L. So what is the moment? What is the moment here? You know WAB by L. This is, if this is A and this is B and the length is your L. So what is the moment, positive moment here? WAB by L. So W into L by 3 into 2 L by 3 divided by L. So this is the maximum moment here. A simply supported bending moment diagram is triangle with maximum ordinate RC here equal to W into L by 3 into 2 L by 3 divided by L. W A B by L. So this is equal to 2 W L by 9. You see, this is triangle, and if the from this to this distance is your A, and if this to this is your B, and the length of the triangle is your L. So what is the central distance from this side? You have to take L plus B by 3. And what is the central distance from this side? L plus A by 3. You have to remember this one. L plus A by 3. Centroid of an unsymmetrical triangle. The centroid of the simply supported BMT is obtained using the above formula as 4L by 9 from the end A and 5L by 9 from the end B. Here you see, this is unsymmetrical triangle. This side L by 3, from this to this L by 3. And from this to this, 12 by 3. So you find out from this side the centroidal distance. So what you have to take this side means L plus 12 by 3 by this one, 3, L plus B by 3. So here this side, L plus 12 by 3 by 3. This is your 5L by 9. And if you are taking from this side, so what is the L plus L by 3 divided by 3? This is equal to 4L by 9 from the end A. Then what is the area of the 3 BMT? What is the area of this one? You know how to find out the area. Half into base into height. Half into base into height. L into 2 WL by 9. This is equal to WL square by 9. This is the area of this one. And you know you have to find out these two moment M and MP. You have to find out this is the moment or the support A, MA, and support B, the moment is your MB. This is the moment you have to find out using the Clapeyron theorem of three moments, M and MB. Apply Clapeyron theorem of three moment to span A dash A and AB. So first you have to apply to the span A dash A and AB, A dash A and AB. Then you have to apply to the span AB and BB dash. This is the Clapeyron theorem. MA L1 plus 2 MB L1 plus L2 plus MC L2 is equal to minus 6 A1 A1 by L1 minus 6 A2 A2 by L2. Then you know MA is equal to M dash. MA dash is 0 due to simply supported end. Because here you see this end is simply supported because this is A dash A and AB. So here you are taking this is simply supported. So what is the moment here? MA is equal to MA dash is equal to 0. And MB is equal to MA. And MC is equal to MB. MC is equal to MB. Then what is the area of this one? There is no 3 BMT, so area is 0. And what is the area of this triangle? This is WL square by 9. And the length is 0. A dash A length is 0. And AB, the length is small L. And you have to take the centroidal distance small a from this side. If the length is 0, so A1 is also 0. And for this figure, right figure, you have to take the centroidal distance from the right end. So here A2 is equal to 5L by 9. These are the values. So L1 0 and L2 is equal to small L. And moment of inertia is same for both A dash A and AP. So you have to put this value in Clapeyron theorem of three moments. Here you have to put the value after simplification. You'll get this is the equation. This is the equation. So finally, you'll get the equation 2MA plus MB is equal to minus 0.37 WL. This is equation 1. Then apply Clapeyron theorem of three moment to span AB and BB dash. You have to apply to span AB and BB dash. So here, this is area WL square by 9. And here, this is 0 span, area 0. And the length is also 0. And the length of AB is small L, and you have to take, you are taking this is right side and this is left. Left figure means you have to take the centroidal distance from the left side. A2 is equal to 4L by 9. This is the centroidal distance, and here the centroidal distance from the right side, but here as this is 0 span length, so the centroidal distance is 0. This is equation 2. this is MA is equal to, this case MA is equal to MA, MB is equal to MB, and MC is equal to MB dash. MA is equal to MA, MB is equal to MB, and MC is equal to MB dash, and this is zero due to simply supported AND. Zero due to simply supported AND. Then these are the values A1, A2, small A1, small A2, L1, L2. And after putting these in Clapeyron theorem, you will get this is the second equation. MA plus 2MB is equal to minus 0.296W into L. This is the second equation. Then after simplification of these two equations, you will get the value of the moment at A and B. MA is equal to minus 0.148WL and MB is equal to minus 0.074WL. So this is the moment here. Here the moment is your 0.148WL and here the moment is your 0.074WL and you know what is the total free BMD, the positive moment, total ordinate 0.0986WL and after overlapping the negative and positive, so this portion is your cancel each other, so this is the negative and this is negative and this is the positive. This is the bending moment diagram of the fixed plane. So this is the, you have to find out this one. Already I have explained in three moment theorem how to find out this one. You have to find out this maximum positive moment here. Then after getting this moment A and B, then you have to find out the reactions. You have to take, this is negative and this is negative. So MA is your negative means this side you have to take anti-clockwise and for MB is negative. So this side, right side, you have to take clockwise direction. And you have to take the load W. What is the load and moment you are having? You have to consider and you have to find out what is the reaction. You have to find out what is the reaction. Let BAB be the reaction at both end of span AB. Using the static equilibrium equation, we get that is summation of vertical force is equal to zero. You have to take one equation and another equation here is sum of the moment about the A is equal to zero. About the A is equal to zero. So you will get two equation. Then after simplification of these two equation, you will find out what is the reaction at A and B, VB and VA. So VB is equal to 0.26W and VA is equal to 0.74W. After getting this reaction, then you have to find out the shear force at different position. So what is the shear force at B? This is B. So shear force at B is equal to FB is equal to minus VB. FB is minus VB, minus 0.26W. And what is the shear force just right of C? Remain constant. FRC is equal to minus 0.26W. Then what is the shear force just left side of C? This is, you have to include this load, downward load, positive. Minus 0.26W plus W plus 0.74W. Then what is the shear force at A? This is equal to constant, 0.74W. And this is equal to the reaction at A. Then after getting this one, you can plot the shear force diagram. Minus 0.26W, take downward. This is the axis. Below the axis, negative, and above the axis, positive, 0.26W. And this is remain constant up to right of C. Then after C, suddenly this is increases 0.74W. And here, this is remain constant up to A. So this is 0.74W. And this is 0.26W. This is the shear force diagram. If both ends are fixed or one end is fixed, then how to find out the support moments? So using the Clapeyron theorem that we have discussed now. So if the end is your fixed and if there is your two span or three span, also you can find out this manner the support moments using the Clapeyron theorem of three moments. Only have to introduce the zero span at the fixed end, then you have to find out the support moments using the Clapeyron theorem of three moments. Now we'll stop here.